trying to adopt. Girl, you came with some personal trainer.
We're on the run, Sydney. We need a place to hide, to regroup. And you owe me. You owe me ever since I sent you and your backup here is free from the Aura Spider.
Ladies!
What's up, girl?
5 minutes. Attend to...
a cow.
You're not going to do.
No, no, absolutely not. No way. Oh, I don't know, maybe. This sounds crazy, I know, but I dreamt about him, Sydney, many, many times.
So what? I have dreamt about Russell Crowe many, many times, but that doesn't mean I owe him anything. I know you, Melanie. I know what you're capable of and what you're not. And you're not going to some island, which for all we know doesn't even exist.
It does. Believe me, it's an earthly paradise. A place like no other. Filled with sounds and sights and sweet everyday delight. Now it's frozen, out of time. And only Prospero's defeat will restore it.
Jungle Boy, she's not going anywhere with you. She will never deliver the kind of magic you need to fight Prospero. Not because she can't, you understand, but because she won't let herself. She doesn't have the stuff for it. And even if she did, you think I'd let her risk her life for you?
Stand together against your magic against his.
Shut up! You don't know anything about her magic.
I know that Balladeers will write songs about her feats one day. Stars will be named after her. The greatest magician of them all, the Raven
Maids. You think I'd let her run off and get herself killed on some fucking island? Because what happens to me, then? I get sucked back into the Aura Stein, that's what, and I don't think so. Sugar has not worked her fingers to the bone to create a life here, just so you can put it at risk. We're depending on her. Everyone she's set free, accidentally or otherwise, to keep us alive, to keep us in the here and now.
Nothing will happen to her. I protect her. The child warrior protects her. The bluebell doesn't.
I do what you are asking her to do. Either that or you don't care. Why should she risk her life for you? Why should she?
Sissimony, both of you, please.
You better tell him, Melanie. Not that cocky little story about Romeo and Tybalt.
Because he was one-dimensional, and I could direct him, but anyone more willful, more unpredictable.
just hated it when I handed her over to him. I will never forget the look on your face. We were 14. We were trying to save a girl from her destiny, but you couldn't.
No. I will never forget the wind that blew through the city that I Agamemnon took Iphigenia away. Back to Aulis. Back to her dad. And I gave up my magic.
Your fear is what will make you great!
No!
Protected! You cannot harm it!
Yeah? wants a cocktail?
Yeah, so can anyone...
Over here, Tiny. Chet.
You okay?
The book, Chet.
No, this isn't Prospero's book. Prospero's book's in here. This is just some old piece of junk I found at Mr. Shylock's. I found it all over there, and I thought that maybe it might... That maybe you could... Maybe
Chet.
We should... Was that bad?
Don't say anything. For the next 30 seconds, don't talk.
How come? Say to me, one day, brother, you'll be gone from our lives. We'll sit next to the calm ocean under a sky that never clouds. We'll read and play chess and swim and be free.
You'll have it. You'll see.
Okay, I just got off the phone with Mr. Shylock's friend at Columbia, Linda Summers, the ancient language expert, or whatever. She's grading papers, working late. Tonight, if I go right now.
Well, that's great, but okay, remind me why that's a good thing again.
Maybe she knows how we can store the book. Maybe she knows where we can find a real magician. Caliban, I'm in this now, okay? You're not alone. I don't know what I can do, but whatever I can, I will. I will see this through as much as possible.
What is that?
Yeah.
terrible presentiment.